What's up, guys? Sean Nalawani, seannal.com, and it's been a while since I've done a supplement review, and this is a compound that I get asked about quite often. So I wanted to do a video today talking about yohimbine, which has a few different uses, but it's most commonly used as a fat loss supplement. So what is yohimbine? What does it do? Does it actually work? And what's the proper dosage? So yohimbine is a compound that comes from the bark of the yohimbe tree, which is found in Africa. And to keep it simple, it works by increasing the release of adrenaline and noradrenaline. And those bind to fat cells in order to mobilize the fat. And then one of the other big supposed benefits of yohimbine, which hasn't been proven, but it's that it helps to specifically target stubborn fat areas, which would be the lower ab area in men, as well as the oblique area and the hips and thighs in women. And the reason for that is that fat cells have two types of receptors, which are the alpha receptors and the beta receptors. And stubborn fat areas have higher concentrations of alpha receptors. And those are the ones that yohimbine specifically works on. And then on top of its direct fat burning effects, yohimbine can also help to suppress your appetite. And if you're using it pre-workout, then it can help to increase your overall energy levels as well. Now, does yohimbine actually work? The short answer is that it probably does help with fat loss a bit, but only to a small degree. I'd say within the scope of what's available in terms of fat loss supplements, it's definitely one of the more effective compounds out there. But just like with any supplement, even the ones that technically do work, they aren't going to perform any miracles, and they're just going to be there to give you a small extra boost. Yohimbine does have a decent amount of research behind it. Some of it looks pretty good on paper, but a lot of the studies do have certain limitations that make it hard to figure out if the subjects were actually losing body fat or just water weight, because yohimbine is actually a diuretic as well, and so it can be hard to determine exactly how much of each is being lost. I'm not going to go into all the details of the studies here because I want to keep this video concise and not too technical, but I'll put some links in the description box if you do want to check that out. But the bottom line is that yohimbine probably does have some fat burning effects, but they will be fairly small. You'll probably see a small increase in your overall metabolic rate, a small increase in energy, and a small decrease in appetite. So if you're someone who's trying to diet down to a fairly lean level and you want to fully maximize your results and you're open to supplementation and you have the money to spend, then it could be worth a try in certain contexts. Now, that said, this does come with a very important warning, and it's the main reason why I don't actively recommend yohimbine to people and why I'm really careful about what I say about it. And that is that for a certain percentage of people, it can have pretty serious side effects, specifically in people who are prone to anxiety or panic attacks, especially if it's being combined with other stimulants like caffeine. Yohimbine is highly stimulatory. It increases your heart rate. It increases your blood pressure, and it essentially ramps up your body's fight or flight response. And so if you identify as being someone with any sorts of issues with anxiety in general, I would recommend that you just stay away from yohimbine altogether, because it can really easily trigger additional anxiety and make it worse. And for the modest fat burning effect that you might get, it's really just not going to be worth it. And then besides generalized anxiety, people with bipolar disorder would also want to completely stay away from it, because it can have some pretty serious effects there. Or if you're using any kind of neurological medication, you'll also want to be really careful there too, because there's a lot of interactions that can take place there. So I just stay away from it in that case, or at the very least, make sure to do your research and talk to your doctor as well. Now, if you don't have any anxiety issues and you tolerate stimulants just fine, then yohimbine could be a supplement to experiment with, but I'd only recommend bothering with it if you're already fairly lean and you're just trying to lose that last bit of stubborn fat. And that's because, number one, if you're just starting out on your fat loss phase, or if you're midway through it and you still have a decent amount of fat to lose, fat mobilization isn't going to be a problem for you at that point, and you'll be able to lose fat just fine with a standard cutting diet and training plan without using any fat loss supplements at all. And number two, I wouldn't recommend using yohimbine for an extended period of time just to be on the safe side, because you'll probably develop tolerance to it pretty quickly. The effects on noradrenaline are almost completely lost even after as short as 2 weeks. And so I would say to just use it on an as-needed basis for a short time toward the end of your cutting phase, if you're trying to get particularly lean for a certain event, or maybe if you've hit around 12% body fat and you just want a little push to help you get slightly lower. And if you are going to use it for a longer period of time, then you'll definitely want to make sure you cycle it. Now, in terms of yohimbine dosage, the standard recommended amount is 0.2 milligrams per kilogram of body weight. So assuming you are only using it once you've gotten fairly lean, then the dosage is going to range anywhere from about 5 milligrams for a smaller female up to about 15 milligrams or slightly higher for a male. But make sure to start out low to assess your tolerance first, and then gradually increase from there rather than just taking the full dose all at once, because you want to know how it affects you first before you increase. And also make sure to take it on an empty stomach, because insulin almost completely erases the effects of yohimbine. So you'll ideally want to use it in a fasted state if you can. And one final point to be aware of when it comes to yohimbine is the controversy about the actual potency of the yohimbine supplements that are available. There was a study done on this, which I'll link in the description box. It looked at 49 different yohimbine supplements, and it found that only two brands actually met the label claim, and that in total, the actual amounts ranged from as low as about 20% up to 150% of what was listed. So in some cases, the dosage would be so low that it wouldn't provide any benefit, and in some cases, the dosage would be high enough that you might end up with side effects, even if you think you're taking the proper amount. So just another reason to be cautious and to do your research first before you start using a yohimbine supplement. But bottom line on yohimbine, if you're toward the end of a cutting phase and you're looking for a few percent of extra results to help you lean down further, then yohimbine might assist you. But the effects are gonna be modest either way, and there's still no guarantee that it will work because the research is still inconclusive on just how effective it is. But only use it if you tolerate stimulants well, and you have no issues with anxiety, and use it cautiously by starting out on a lower dose and gradually increasing, and only by using it short term or by cycling it. So I hope you guys found this advice helpful. If you appreciate the no BS science-based approach to fitness and you want to get all the tools you need to gain muscle and lose fat as effectively as possible, the workouts, the meal plans, the supplement guides, along with one-on-one coaching, then you can download my body transformation blueprint by clicking here or by heading over to bodytransformationtruth.com using the link in the description box. If you enjoyed the video, as always, make sure to hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe to stay up to date on future videos. You can also check out my official blog over at seannal.com for all of my latest updates. And you can follow me on social media here if you aren't already. Thanks again for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.